knew she wanted him the moment that she saw him. From the way he wandered in the diner door, he was elegant and arrogant and witty. He was above everyone, could never love anyone. But he was proud and he was vain and he was pretty, which only meant that she would want him all the more. She invited him to come to her apartment, said her parents wouldn't be around that day. When the two of them got down to nitty gritty, and she fell into his lap, but was she laying a trap? 'Cause she was proud and she was vain and she was pretty, and couldn't bear to watch him wandering away. Florentine, I think you did the best that you were able, waitressing and wiping off the tables, and dreaming about the day he'd take you away. Because St. Henry is not exactly living in a fable, it ain't exactly living in Green Gables, Florentine. Florentine. Now a man of his considerable ambition can't be bothered by the breaking of a heart, can't be hindered by compassion or by pity. He made sure he never knew about the Chalcomen deal. He packed his bags and beat a path across the city. We always knew that he would leave her from the start. Struggling.